We'll start detailing the eye sockets by adding more edge loops to the eyelids so they can fully close when animated. Next, we'll add thickness to the eyelids and continue the inside of the eye socket. Select this edge loop and press E to extrude, then G and Y to translate it back a bit. Wrap it against the eyeball and intersect it in a bit so there's no gaps. While shaping, I'll often toggle between shaded and wire view. I'll also toggle between subsurf visibility off and on, subsurf off to ensure that the base geometry cage is kept smooth, and subsurf on for the overall surface appearance. Throughout this section, our focus will be on adding volume and defining creases. My workflow involves using the proportional editing tool and the smooth tool. And for shaping smaller areas needing more detailed precision, I'll edit individual vertex by hand. The eyelids should fit well against the cornea, ensuring no gaps or intersection. We'll select the face mesh and press numpad slash to toggle into local view. Local view displays only selected objects, allowing us to work only the face mesh without other pieces like the eyeball geometry being in the way. I prefer to start by over-exaggerating the creases, defining key landmarks. This middle edge loop defines the eyelid crease. This face loop defines the area for the eyelashes. And this defines the eyelid shelf. We'll continue to add new edge loops and shape them to help bring out more detailed forms. We'll move the camera and lamp in a different layer. Disabling the last button on both Subsurf and Mir enables us to work with the editing cage and view Subsurf updates at the same time. Thickness of the eyelids should be even throughout. And it's better to make the eyelids a little thicker rather than make them too thin. Once the general eye shape is completed, we'll add the tear duct. Press V to rip. Fill the hole with new faces. And shape. Going back to readjust the eye placement a bit more. And then readjusting the inside eye sockets to match the new eye placement.